So it's been a while since I did a video and did the editing for a video, and I've had technical difficulties between the last video and this video, so enjoy the next part of this video clip.
Here are probably around July 15th, I'll have enough saved up to buy a motorcycle or to buy a Chevy Astro van or possibly another minivan. Those are the three that I'm looking at. If I do minivan, I'd like to find a Toyota in good condition for around 2,000 bucks, something like that. Just because that I've been told Toyotas hold up better. You know, I could also make a Toyota four-door car work if I tore all the seats out in order to live in it and do a DoorDash and Uber. But the general idea is I want to head toward Spearfish, South Dakota around July 15th, which is 2 months from now, because I figure 40 or 50 bucks a day DoorDashing, and that's probably what it's going to take me to raise the funds here to buy a vehicle to go there. And then I think around somewhere around July 15th is Hills Alive, which is a Christian music festival in Rapid City, South Dakota. And so I would get the one-way drive, you know, trip up there, hang out with my mom at that, and then I would split ways from her and go and stay in Rapid City while she comes back to Shattern. And then I would buy a vehicle from the Rapid City area, would be my guess, somewhere in that ballpark. There's a nice, I think it was like an Indian or an off-brand name motorcycle for $1,500 in Hermosa, and the guy might sell it to me for less than that if it's still there by the middle of July. Then I might go that route. Then I'd have to head up to Montana to get my motorcycle license for it, the endorsement on it, on my license for a motorcycle. But I'm thinking about doing a motorcycle for Uber Eats and DoorDash, just because fuel efficiency and parking is really nice. The only downside is watching the drinks. You know, you have to build like a foam drink container in a cooler, you know, so that you keep your drinks solid when they give them to you. But motorcycle wise would be the way to go in terms of Uber Eats or DoorDash in nice weather like this. But then I have the issue of the winter coming again, like I have every winter, because I'm a spoiled snowbird, and would want to go down to Arizona again or someplace where next winter where it doesn't snow, because I don't like snow. So I might end up buying a Toyota minivan or a Chevy Astro van because of that, and it also gives me somewhere to sleep and to store my stuff. So it might be van life first and then motorcycle, or it might be motorcycle camping and then van life. I don't know. It just depends on what I can afford. For somewhere between $1,500 and $2,000, that's still drivable, because I hate how these people mark they want $2,000 for what is basically a parts car that doesn't even run or drive, and they still want their money back for it when it doesn't run. I think that's very stupid. I mean, if your vehicle won't run because your transmission won't go into gear, or the vehicle itself won't start and run, or it doesn't have the right tires and whatnot to run, it should be counted as a parts car and sell that thing for $500 to $700. It shouldn't be having to try to get your money's worth at $2,000 worth and then make somebody have to go fix it on top of that, in my opinion. But some people try their hardest to get their money back. So I'll begin search for a motorcycle or a minivan or an Astro van sometime in the middle of July. And then I'm going to start this YouTube channel going more between now and then, doing DoorDash, possible DoorDash videos again. But I tried that in Spearfish, and every time I got on to the thing, DoorDash was so busy there that I couldn't make a decent enough video to do it content-wise. But maybe Shattern, Nebraska is slower. It does have slower times here, and so maybe I can talk about the orders in between when I get them, and how much I took for where and when and why, and all the DoorDashing stuff for people who want to be DoorDashers or Uber Eats drivers. And Uber Eats doesn't exist here in Shattern, Nebraska. I'm signed up for it, but I'm going to get on the Spark list and Uber Eats for Rapid City when I go up there in July. But for the next 2 months, it'll be DoorDashing for 40 or 50 bucks a day here every single evening, saving up until I can get a minivan, Astro van, or motorcycle. And I'll make video content on the DoorDashing part of it from this point on. But I just wanted to show you kind of where I'm living and an update, since I haven't done an update since Arizona. Considering bringing back my expediting channel as a second travel channel, and I haven't decided exactly for sure on what yet to do with it. One might be van life type of channel, and the other one might be the gig work for DoorDash and Uber Eats and Spark. Or I might do one as an Uber Eats channel and one as a DoorDashing channel. I don't know yet for sure, but pretty sure that's the way my life is going to go, because after sitting here thinking about it, I still want to be not unemployed. No, I still want to be self-employed, because going back to work for a boss, it's just not my thing. I'm too spoiled to do that, too. So I'm a spoiled snowbird, and I got spoiled into working for myself, is what it comes down to. But I think DoorDash, especially when you're living in the van, can more than pay my bills that I need every month for living the van life. And I can take DoorDash with me anywhere I want, and I work whenever I can afford to or not. I think that's the best way to go. And then, obviously, my driver's foot can't put up with 600 miles a day anymore. The expediting or the transporting vehicles was too much. But I think DoorDash at 50 or 100 miles a day is not going to be a problem for it. Doesn't seem to hurt as much nowadays. So anyway, there's my update. Stay tuned for future DoorDashing. Like and subscribe, leave comments, and I'll catch you in the flip piece.